हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज स्मृति शर्मा एंड आई एम बैक विद द सेम टॉपिक टॉपिक वी स्टार्टेड द लास्ट टाइम, बी टू बी कॉमर्स. सो टुडे वी विल बी गोइंग अहेड एंड वी विल बी सीइंग हाउ वी विल बी मेकिंग द वेबसाइट एंड हाउ विल बी प्रोसीडिंग विद बी टू बी कॉमर्स. ओके, So this is a small introduction where I will let you know that what are the main topics which we will be covering as a part of this video. So we will be creating a new playground org. Second thing, we will be enabling the digital experiences. Third thing, we will be enabling the commerce. And fourth, we will be enabling the order management. So a new playground org will be needed in the Salesforce so that we can create a new website with the help of the Salesforce itself. Enable digital experience. This is the same thing which we will be doing on the Salesforce. I will let you know how, so that how the digital experience has been enabled and how it will help us to create the websites. Third is enable commerce. This is again another important thing which will help us that all the important objects related to the commerce, for example, the payment options, the other relevant objects which are needed to make a website, that will be populated inside the Salesforce. Earlier it won't be there, but as soon as we will be enabling the commerce, that objects will be getting in the Salesforce so that we can reuse them. Okay, so these are built-in objects which will be getting created. Fourth is enable the order management. So for any if you are placing any type of order, for example, in Amazon, if you place any of the order for any of the products, so related to any of the order number, related to how many products you have purchased, or you know, what is the balance, what is the payment, all these type of order related things, that will be enabled using the order management. Okay, now this is the digital experiences. I will let you know how to enable the digital experiences. Okay, so let's go to the org. Okay, so this is our org. I have already enabled these things, but I will let you know that how will it appear. Okay, so with me you can just enable it on your system. First of all, we will go to the setup. Okay, and in setup you can just search the digital experiences. Right now these five things are appearing: all sites, pages, settings, templates and themes. But if you look at the presentation, whenever you open this digital experience, you won't be able to see all the options because it is still not enabled. Whenever you open this digital experience, you will see this type of page and you just have to click on save. Once you click on the save, this digital experiences will be enabled and then you will be able to see like we are seeing on the org. These five sites: all sites, pages, setting, templates and themes. Okay. Now this digital experiences has helped us to enable the new roles. Okay, now we will be going to the settings. Okay, so settings, you can check that if all the settings has been enabled here. One thing, these are all the default settings. Okay, so these settings will help the default profile so that customer can log in and to check any type of profiles, they can use the profile section. I will show you that profile section as well. But for now, we are just keeping it as default. Only one thing I have checked here is allow using standard external profiles for sales registration. Only this one you can click if it is not clicked in your or else just this and click on save. Okay. So these are the profiles which will be enabled as a part of that. You can see that here you can see so many profiles: customer, community, user, okay, external identify user, custom sales profile. So there are some profiles which has been added so that we can use it while constructing the website. Okay. And we can you can always use it. You can just clone it, make a copy of it, and make it and use it as per your requirements. And then you can use these, because exactly these ones are already created by Salesforce. But yeah, you can just clone these and you can use it as per your requirement. Now, next thing is you have to apply the commerce. So this is the enable commerce, where new objects getting created after enabling commerce like payment, shipping address needs to be these type of payment, shipping address, these needs to be stored somewhere. So that's why we are enabling the commerce, so that new objects start getting created. Okay, so let me show you. Okay, so you can see that if you go to commerce setting, while creating the this page right now, also in the PPT also I have taken the same screenshot, but you can just enable the commerce. There is a green toggle here. I have already done it, that's why it's coming as already done. Okay, disabled. But in your system you can just enable the commerce and click on save. Okay, so now this will start creating the objects which are you need for the creating the commerce website. Okay, now here I have shown you that when you will search in the object manager, where all the objects are there, when you will, before enabling the commerce, if you search on store, okay, you won't find any of the stores here. Okay, but once you enable the commerce and if you now search on store, you can see that there is store options, store buyer group, store catalog, store price book. These are some of the objects which Salesforce has enabled it. Okay, once you have enabled the commerce, so remember this thing, that this is very important. Okay, to enable the commerce so that relevant objects related whichever we need to create the website, that gets enabled on the Salesforce itself. So one more, let me try buyer. So you can see buyer account, buyer criteria, buyer group. So these are also some of the objects which are enabled once we have enabled the commerce. Okay, so next and the last is the order setting. So you can just check whenever you will search the order setting, it will appear like this. Okay, so you can enable orders from default, it has been set, and you can click on save. Let me show you on the org as well. So this is the order settings, and for me I have already enabled it. So if it is not enabled in your system, you can just see that blue ticks have been there for enable orders and enable optional price book for orders, and click on save. So this is the order settings. So these four things we have already done. Okay, now what is the next thing? Okay, now we will go to the org and we will search for commerce. Okay, so next thing is, like, we will be going to the commerce. So from here you can just go to commerce and switch on the commerce app. Now you can see here the commerce. I am closing my other website. Okay, so this is the commerce which has been enabled. Okay, so as soon as you go to the commerce app, you can see there are options here. Okay, to create a store using the commerce template, merchandising, where manage products and add images, rich media and translations to them. Pricing option is there, where you can update and manage the price book and price book entries. Commerce setup, install commerce reports and configure product variations and content. So these are the five things, links, quick links which appear as soon as we go to the commerce app. Now we will be setting up a store. So let me start to create a store here. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so I will, there are two options here, to create a store on existing site and create a store. So this is my older store which I have created. So for today, to show you, I will be creating a new store. Okay, so here you will see three options: B2B store, commerce reorder portal, B2C store. So we will be start selling with B2B store. Okay, you can use the lighter version as well. This is the commerce reorder portal. This is very light version, so we won't be using right now. We will be using full version, so we will be going with B2B store. Click on next. Okay, now here I will choose country. Default language, let's keep it as English. Store name. Okay, so what store name should we keep? E-commerce cart. Okay, let me keep it like this. Okay, now start selling. Okay, so this is the store which is getting created. Okay, now you can see that here it is creating a site. Okay, so let me wait for the site to get created so that I can let you know further what we needs to do. So Salesforce has already started to make the e-commerce website. Okay, which name is e-commerce cart. Okay, now website is getting created. I will let you know in the digital, in the setup, if you search digital experiences. Okay, so digital experience, we have will be going to all sites. So you can see that this is the URL which we can see, e-commerce cart. So it is created here. So that's why it is shown here. Okay. Now you can click on the builder. And from here, we can see that the site is created. Let me click on OK. Okay. So preview here, it is the preview button. Reload it. Okay, so now you can see that this is the website which is created. This is generally a default type of website. We will be making changes as per our needs to this. But yeah, this is the starting phase of this website which we have created. Okay. From back to builder, you can. Okay, so let's come to our org. Okay, this will this is already what I have shown you. Now let me create a catalog for this. Okay, so this is the content manager. You can see that here we have catalog, search, import, administrator, orders. This is all the things. So first we will be creating a catalog. Okay, so catalog, let me keep it as e-commerce cart catalog. Okay. Store, it is already taken it as this, so let me save it. Okay, a catalog is already created. Okay, so let me go to the catalog here. So by default, two gets created. Okay, if you see that wholesale catalog, e-commerce cart catalog has been created. Let me delete this, okay, so that here we can create it. Let me delete from here. Now we will be able to create it. Okay, now you see that we will be able to create it. From default it is already taken, so that's why I have to delete it. Okay, so now you can see in the catalogs we have this e-commerce cart catalog. Okay, so now we will add the categories on our catalog. Okay, so let me create a categories here. I will click on create category. So this is category page. I will select, for example, home decor. Okay, so this is our category. And parent category we don't have, home related items available. Okay, now this is sort order where you can keep 10, 20 or 30. Where I'm just keeping it as 20. Okay, so sort order is used to basically arrange the categories. Okay, for example, if I will show you Amazon website, amazon.in. okay, so you can see here these are our subtitles, subcategories. So here you can see that Echo and Alexa is first. Okay, meet Alexa, Alexa skills. So this is arranged in a specific order. So if you want to change the orders, so for example, meet Alexa you want to keep at the end. So basically to sort or rearrange the orders, we need this sort order. Okay, so let's keep it as 10, 20 or 30. Okay, so that will help us. And let me click on save. Okay, so this is the first category which is created. Let me create one more category. So one more category is, let me select clothes. Okay, so this is clothes for men and women. Okay, sort order I am again keeping as 10. And click on save. So if you come here, you will see that we have two categories here. Okay, now if I go to home decor, we need to add the products as well here. Okay, so to add the products, we can click here and we can, you know, add here or assign products. If you click on assign products, you will see that there are pre-configured products, okay, which are already there. But I don't want these products to be configured. I want to add my own products. Okay, so I will go to products. Or product workspace also we can add. Okay, so if you click on product workspace, so these here you will find all the products here. So I just want to add my own products. Okay. So this is the add product. Okay, so we will be adding the products from here. Okay, and when the products are created, we can check on the product workspace. So let me create some products for us. Okay, so first product I will be creating is men shoes. Okay, product family I will not add. Here I can add the code M1001 shoes. ओके, शूज अवेलेबल फॉर मेन. And I will keep it as active. Okay, so this is the product which I have created, men's shoes. One more product I will be creating it. Another product I will be creating is wooden cupboards. Okay, product code will be W. 1002 B B wooden cupboards available. Okay, and I will make it as active. And then again click on save. Okay, I will create one more product. I will be creating four products. Okay, so next product I will be creating is let's say women handbags. Okay, so H1003 HB. Okay, different types of handbags. Oh, active. Let's make it active. I can edit that. Okay, so this is the third product, and one more product I will create is kitchen appliances. Okay, kitchen appliances. K10004 and K. Kitchen related items. Okay, making it active and then save. Okay, so now we have four products which are there. So let me check on the one more thing we can do. We can add the 1 second. Okay, so we can, for example, if I am going to kitchen appliances, I can add the price for this. Okay, so here is the price book option. So you can just add, go to this price book. Okay. I am going to this price book and add the standard price for the products. Okay, so this is the kitchen appliances and the list price I am keeping it as 1500. Okay, so this is the standard price which we will be using. Okay, so basically from the price book we can add price on the products. Okay, through the price book save. So let me add for all the products. Women handbags. Again, from price book, you can add the price. Add the standard price. So, handbags, I'm keeping it as 500. Cupboards, price book, you can see zero. I'm again adding the standard price for this. So, this is cupboards. So, I'm keeping it as 10,000. And then men's shoes. Again, price book. I'm adding the standard price as for the men shoes I am keeping it as 1200. Okay, so we have added all the products what we need for our categories, and also we have added the price, standard price for that. Now you can just go to the product workspace. Now you will find all the products which you have created here. See, in the end you can see men's shoes, wooden cupboards, wooden handbags and kitchen appliances. Okay, go here, the categories are missing here on the products. Okay, so now what we will do, we will map the products to the categories. So we will be going to the product workspace where all the products are there, and I will just click here and I will click okay, so one thing I want to do here is let me go to product here. Okay, and here we have the men's shoes. Okay, so this I just want to edit as not men's shoes. Okay, I will keep it as men's shorts. Okay, so here we have shorts available for men. Okay, now I will go to the product workspace. Now again we will go here and I will just click here wooden cupboards and kitchen appliances. Okay, and I will add to category here. So women cupboards and kitchen appliances. Okay, so we will add it as home decor because we have these two categories, right? Clothes and home decor. And then click on save. Okay, so now you can see that women cupboards and kitchen appliances you can see as home decor. Now men shorts and women handbags, this we will add it to clothes. Okay, because shorts are also clothes and handbags also I am keeping for now in the clothes category. So I'm just keep clicking on save. So now you can see that all for all the four items the categories have been added. Now let's go to the site. Okay, so you can see that today we have got the site here, but it is still under construction. So we will be going to the setup and we will be checking here. Clicking on all sites. And here we have the URL for that. So you can just click on builder. And we can check with the preview. So you can see that options are getting available. Clothes, home decor and products. So if you click on clothes. Okay, it's not available right now. Okay. I have to add store here, assign the store here, then it will be added. Okay, so I will be going to okay e-commerce. Okay, so I will be going here. This is the product, I don't need this. Okay, so I'm just checking if I can delete this. So you have seen that we have made it inactive, so now I'm not able to see that product one. So only clothes and home decor we have. Okay, for now the products are not visible here. You can see that I have clicked on home decor, but the product, it's not visible, though it is added here. Okay, so what we will do is we will click on search, and this is the rebuild index. So rebuild index we will do so that the inside the home decor, the all the products are visible. Okay, so and we restored that. To restore that, okay, so we'll click on rebuild index, full reindex, rebuild. It will take some time, so till that time I'll wait. See, it is completed, and now you can see the products. So now I will click on builder and we will check here. So now I think the products will be configured here, and I will click on preview. So now you can see the clothes and home decor is appearing, and if I click on home decor, oh wow, kitchen appliances and wooden cupboards are appearing. If you click on kitchen appliances, then yes, so you can see here the price is also available here, what we have said in dollars. I have included that in the rupees, but here it is configured to dollars. And if I click on clothes, now you can see the men shorts and women handbags appearing. And if you click on men women handbags, you can see the price also available. Okay, so this is the you need to do this rebuild index if it is not appearing in your site. Okay, so I think that's all for today. We will continue on the next session, the other things, whatever is available. Still we have so many things to set up. This is store setup. If you see that we still have so many things available appearing here, which we will be building later on. So we have already built a store, we have created the products, okay, catalog is also done and categories is also done. Okay, so from next session I will continue. Till then, please try to create your own website, create your own categories, store, as well as you can add your own products as per your site, and try to create that. And let me know in the comment section if you have any of the issues. We'll try to resolve that. And that's all. If you like this video, please like and subscribe our channel. And thank you so much.